Welcome, everyone. Today, we are going to embark on an exciting journey into the world of abstract expressionism. In this lesson, we will explore the works of three renowned artists, Lee Krasner, Joan Mitchell, and Jackson Pollock. These artists were a part of a movement that challenged traditional art forms and allowed artists to convey their emotions and attitudes through non-traditional and non-representational means. Let's begin by understanding what abstract expressionism is. It is an artistic movement of the mid-20th century that emphasized an artist's freedom to express their thoughts and emotions in unconventional ways. Action painting, a technique used by abstract expressionist artists, involved dripping, splattering, or smearing paint onto the canvas to create a sense of movement and energy. To better understand this concept, we will take a closer look at the artworks of our three artists, Lee Krasner's Untitled from 1964, Joan Mitchell's Untitled from 1957, and Jackson Pollock's Number One Lavender Mist from 1950. These artworks showcase extreme abstraction and a dynamic interplay between figurative and non-figurative elements. Joan Mitchell was an American painter who was known for her large abstract expressionist paintings. Her artworks were inspired by nature and landscapes, which she translated into abstract forms. Jackson Pollock was an American painter who was famous for his unique style of drift painting. He used household paints and enamel to create large-scale paintings with complex textures and patterns. Lee Krasner was an American abstract expressionist painter, and her paintings were characterized by strong brushwork and the use of vivid colors. Now let's familiarize ourselves with some important vocabulary. Abstract expressionism is the artistic movement that we're exploring today. Action painting is a technique that involves expressive brushstrokes and gestures. Gesture refers to a quick and expressive movement made with a hand or body to convey feelings or ideas. Palette refers to the range of colors used by an artist in a particular work or series of works, and texture refers to the surface quality of a work of art created through the artist's use of materials. I'm going to demo very quickly what these different movements are that you can use during this project. The first one is going to be the splatter of paint. So we're going to get a dollop of paint loaded onto our paintbrush, and we're just going to toss it right onto the canvas that we're using just by flicking your wrist. The second one that we're using, you can also smear your paint. So all you do is you're going to lay down some paint with a paintbrush, and then you're going to smear it. You could do that by using your paintbrush, your fingers, or paint palette knives. In this case, we are using tongue depressors for this demonstration. After that, you can also use masking tape. You'll lay down some paint and then you'll put the masking tape on top of it, and you could press it into it and take it off to create that texture. And then you can also drip paint. And by that, you can just open up the paint bottle, turn it over, and then squeeze and move around your hand to get that all dripped onto the canvas. Now that we have learned about abstract expressionism vocabulary, as well as seen a demonstration of ways that you can use your paint, you will now be put into groups of four with eight students in each of them, and then we will go ahead and get started. The materials that you'll get today in your groups are going to include gloves so that you keep your hands from getting dirty, a variety of paint brushes so that you can use those to splatter, drip, and smear paint. Tongue depressors or paint palette knives will be given as well, that way you can create texture. A variety of paint colors will be given to your groups to use during this project. And the last item that you'll be receiving is masking tape as well. That way, if you wanted to try to include that texture that we talked about earlier, you may. During this activity, the eight members of your groups will be going in 2-minute intervals to take one turn each on the canvas. During this time, you'll be using your paint palettes as well as the various techniques that we've talked about, such as drips, splatters, and smears of paint. You can also use your fingers, the palette knives or tongue depressors, and masking tape and brushes to create that texture and patterns in your paintings. So let's go ahead and begin. And once your 2 minutes are up, you will hear this noise. Once hearing that, you will stop what you're doing and the next person will go ahead and start their 2 minutes. And then at the very end, we'll take a look to see what we've created together. As we've seen, abstract expressionism is a movement that defies easy categorization. It encompasses a wide range of styles, techniques, and approaches, but what unites them is a sense of freedom and emotion. By breaking away from traditional forms and conventions, abstract expressionists created a new language of art that speaks to our innermost feelings and aspirations. So the next time you encounter an abstract expressionist painting, take a moment to pause, reflect, and immerse yourself in its energy and beauty. Who knows, you might discover something about yourself and the world around you that you never knew before. Thanks for watching and see you next time.